setting young men's heart aflutter all over the world, and most certainly in Britain. Indeed, in an interview in the Chicago Tribune recently, you said, fans over in Britain never forget you. And if you look at that screen, we're going to prove it now by going to London to hear from just some of those loyal fans of yours, and you won't be at all surprised to see that in Britain, it's tea time. Tea time at the Waldorf, hosted by the founder of the Alice Faye Appreciation Society, Arthur Nicholson.
Hello, Alice. Here we are in London having tea at the Waldorf. If it's any good, next time you're over, we'll bring you here. It's lovely to be able to say hello to you on this great night, and it couldn't go to a more deserving lady. Have a wonderful, wonderful evening, dear.
He sent you his first fan letter to Hollywood 45 years ago. Here he is, Arthur Nicholson. Needless to say, you've seen all Alice Faye's films. What's your all-time favorite?
Alexander's Ragtime Band.
Well, special treat for Arthur then, and your millions of fans. Here you are with the late Tyrone Power in Alexander's Ragtime Band.
Sing.
Come on in here, come on in here, Alexander's Ragtime Band. Come on in here, come on in here, it's the best band in the land. They can play a bugle call like you never heard before. So natural that you wanna go to war. That's just the best band what I am on the honey land.
If you could choose any co-star that you would like to maybe bump into again, Alice, that you haven't seen lately. I know it's from left field. Now, I want the audience to know that this dialogue is 100% totally spontaneous. People always want, are there pre-production meetings? We just let it flow. If there could be one that you would bump into that you would...
Well, you know, Tyrone Power is gone. Jack Opie is gone. I see John Payne once in a while. Don I see once in a while. But I'd like to see them all again. People, all together.
People, when you give the lectures, do they sometimes... Because everybody's so interested nowadays in yesteryear's studio and the star system. And
these people are wonderful out there. They ask the darndest questions. They're full of life.
Like a personal thing? Like, were the stars well paid? They ask you these things?
Or they want to ask you. They ask, well, who was your favorite leading man? And how did Don Ameche kiss? And
how did Don Ameche kiss?
Oh, heavenly.
Heavenly.
Yeah.
How did Tyrone Power kiss?
Heavenly.
Al Jolson?
I don't know.
In between.
I didn't kiss him.
No. But he wanted you in that, in Rose of Washington Square. He wanted you badly. Uh-huh. Mm-hmm. How about...
I see Ruby Keeler a lot. She lives right nearby me.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
Good lady.
Oh, do I remember it? Henry King film.
He was so wonderful. He meant a lot in my life. He really did.
Why is that?
He just polished the apple. He really did.
So nice to hear an actor speaking with such affection about a director.
I loved him. He was different than anybody I'd ever worked with or even met. I mean, he was a man. You know, you just had to look up at Henry King and say he's the greatest.
The reason that Zanuck did that film was that MGM had a film called San Francisco 2 years earlier that had worked. Mm-hmm. And it ended up in this with a sort of disaster ending on it. And Zanuck said, well, we can do that here. So that was the way he came up with In Old Chicago. That was the genesis of the film. Mm-hmm. At that time, when you would work on a film like that, were they interested in your thoughts or your reactions or your input? Did they say, well, what do you think about this character? Or do you think that the scene can work?
No, they never asked us.
You just showed up and you did whatever the work was, whatever the lines
were. But Henry King did. Henry King was the one that said, well, how do you feel? You know, and I think, well, this man, he must be kidding. You know, because there's something wrong here, you know. How do you feel about this? Are you comfortable? I'd say, yes, I. Maybe if I, you know, maybe if I, instead of coming down the stairs this way, maybe if I tried it this way, I'd like to try it that way. And he'd say, that's what I want you to do. And it was entirely different. I'd never had anybody talk to me like that. And he loved Tyrone, and he loved Don Amici. It was really very important in our lives.
He also directed you in Alexander's Ragtime Band.
Yeah.
Which was then and is now a classic.
Everybody's doing it, doing it, doing it. Everybody's doing it, doing it, doing it. See that ragtime couple over there? Watch them throw their shoulders in the air. Snap their fingers, honey, I declare. It's a bear, it's a bear, it's a bear. There, everybody's doing it.
Doing it, doing it.
Everybody's doing it.
Doing what?
Turkey drop, ain't that music touching your heart? Hear that trombone busting apart. Come, 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 let us start. Everybody's doing it.
Everybody's doing it.
Everybody's doing it now.
Whenever I say to you, why do you like a film? It always comes down to the people. In the case of Alexander's Ragtime Band, it was you and Tyrone Power and Don Amici. Mm-hmm. You were like the Three Musketeers, and
yeah,
it sounds to me like you felt you were with friends, and
like children, crying out loud. You know, we'd work and get real silly sometimes. You know, like they would. We all had movable dressing rooms. You know, that you on the set that you could on wheels, and they'd get real silly and give mine a push when I was in there with a hairdresser or something, and it'd go down the street. It wasn't very funny,
yeah.
If it would have hit something, but you're there from 6:30 in the morning till you know 7-8 at night. You got to start doing something, or you'll go crazy.
Yeah.
You know, you have to start playing tricks on one another.
Yeah.
Well, Merman got into it, then she was. She nailed Ty's shoes to the floor in his dressing room, you know. And, I mean, it was like then Henry King had to come in and say, listen, you know, we have to get nursemaids for each one, you know.
Yeah.
But it was one of the, we had a lot of fun.
Do you find younger people have seen your films, that they've seen?
Some of them. It's marvelous, yeah. A lot of the youngsters like those musicals, and they like the songs, and they send me pictures to music. To autograph, you know, Irving Berlin's, they save them, and there's quite a few. It's amazing.
Sing. Sing.
Come on in here, come on in here, Alexander's Ragtime Band. Come on in here, come on in here, it's the best band in the land. They can play a bugle call like you never heard before. So natural that you want to go to war. That's just the best band what I am. Oh, my honey lamb, come on along, come on along. Let me take you by the hand. Up to the man, up to the man, who's the leader of the band. And if you care to hear the Sunny River play, come on in here, come on in here.
Glad that you had that 9 years, that 10 years. Are you happy that you had
a film?
A film work?
Oh, that was my. I loved it.
Really?
It was the real thrill of my life. It's what I strived for as a kid in New York, sitting on a fire escape. I mean, wow, it's my penthouse, and I'm really very busy today, and you know, I have so much to do, and always been that way, and so it was a dream. It was a great big beautiful bubble, and it happened. It happened.